Hello all, today we are going to talk about graphs. Okay, we'll keep ourselves limited to some graphs which we encounter in physics, generally in 11th science. Okay, in class 11th, since students are new and you guys have to learn a lot of graph concepts, actually every topic of physics can somehow contain this. So what is graph? In graph, we represent change in something, change in one thing with respect to another. Okay. So in graph, generally we represent change in something with respect to another. Now, it's very useful concept in physics, and of course it comes, we borrow this ideas from mathematics. So to begin with, if I start with y equal to x, suppose I give you one equation where y is equal to x. Now this thing in physics, it is called in mathematics it is called y is a function of x. So if I write an equation like this, or if I write an equation like y equal to x square or anything, so y is said to be a function of x. Okay, now x here, this x is called independent variable. This is called independent, and this is called dependent. Now, when I say y is a function of x, then in mathematics, we just write it like this. Fine. We read this as y is a function of x. Okay, this is not multiplication, it is just a symbol for function of x. Now, why it is independent, why it is dependent? Because x, suppose you make it 1, then y automatically get fixed, right? If you make x 1 here, then y automatically get fixed, and if you make x equal to 2, then y value get automatically fixed. That's why it is called dependent and independent variable. Now, second thing, in graph we will learn the slope. There is a concept that is called slope, and slope here is rise by run. And in mathematics it is also called perpendicular by base, but it is nothing but it is tan theta. Okay, so there is one more concept that is called slope. Okay, and we'll use this thing, and this is very important concept, that dependent, independent and so on. Now let us start with the simplest example. So suppose I give you y equal to x. Now how to draw it? You will draw x axis, y axis, and you can see if x is 0, y is 0, so I can take one point here. If x is 1, y is 1, so if you go like that, y equal to x will give you this line. Okay, it will pass through the origin. Now in this quadrant x is negative, so y will automatically be negative. Now this, from the x-axis, if you measure the angle in this way, in anticlockwise direction, this is called, let us say, theta. Theta is the angle, so tan theta is called slope. Fine. And actually it is, in mathematics it is denoted by m. I don't know the reason, but this is the slope. Fine. Now if you see this equation, now suppose I give you this equation, y equal to minus x, then how to draw this? So in this case, see, if x is 0, y is 0. If x is positive, y is negative. So this is x, this is y,
So if x is positive, y is negative. This is negative y. So turns out that it goes something like this. And if you measure the angle in this way, this will be the angle theta and tan theta will be slope. Now we say the same equation, this equation can be represented as y equal to tan 45 degree into x. Okay, and you guys know tan 45 degree is 1. So in this case, actually y equal to x, this theta will be 45 degree only, right? Tan 45 is cos for sine by cos, so you will find this to be 1, so you will get this. Now this is nothing but 90 plus this, so the same equation can be written as y equal to minus tan 45 times x. Okay, now how come it is minus 1045? So this is 90, this is 45, so this is 135. Actually, this is 135. But if I measure this angle in clockwise, anti-clockwise angles are positive. Okay, this angles are positive and this angles are negative. This is 45. So the same thing can be written in two ways. I can write like this, okay, or I can also write the same thing equal to tan 135 times x, and you will find tan 135 is nothing but this. So generally this equations we write y equal to x, y equal to this, we generally write y equal to mx, where m is the slope. Okay, slope means tan theta, or y equal to minus mx. Fine. Again, let me say that the angle measured in anticlockwise is considered to be positive. Angle measured in in clockwise direction is considered to be negative. Okay, so this graph will have two representation. Fine. Now, again, m is tan theta, nothing but tan theta. Now, if I just write this equation, y equal to, I have written x, if you have to draw y equal to 2x, what will be the difference? Now you guys know, here this is nothing but slope, slope is 1 here. Here slope is 2, so if y equal to x is this one, okay, this is 45 or whatever, slope is 1 here, slope is 2 here, so the y equal to 2x will be something like this, y equal to 2x, its slope will be more, this angle will be more, okay. And you can see that this slope can become maximum up to 90 degree. After that, slope will become obtuse and it will decrease. Fine. Now, moving on, there is one more equation, y equal to mx plus c. This is called equation of straight line in slope intercept form. Okay, this is called equation of a straight line in slope intercept form. M is the slope, this is called intercept. Now, how to draw this? So again, put x equal to 0. So if you put x equal to 0, y turns out to be c, right? So let us say c is this. And m is the slope, which is positive. So it turns out this is y equal to mx plus c graph. If you write y equal to mx minus c, then it turns out if you put x equal to 0, then y turns out to be minus c. So there was plus c here, minus c, let us say, is here, and slope is positive. Okay, this slope is this one, this is the angle. So this turns out to be like this, and this is the positive slope. Okay, I'm just writing theta, tan theta is the slope. Now you can write the same equation like y equal to minus mx minus c. How to draw this? So if you put x equal to 0, y is minus c, but you can also see this slope is negative. So there is a minus c here and slope is negative. So it turns out that this line will go like this, and it will have a slope. This is negative slope. Okay, either you measured in this way, this is obtuse, so 10 obtuse angle will be negative, or if you measured in this way, in clockwise direction, then also it will be negative. So this has negative slope. And if y equal to, I give you minus mx plus c, then this equation, if you draw, if x equal to 0, y is c, but slope is negative, so it turns out this line will go something like this, and again this will be the slope. Okay, it is obtuse, so it is going to be negative. Now the same expression, now any equation in which y and x are related in such a way that it is in first order, or x has one power only, x has power 1, all this equation represent a straight line. Okay, now in physics, of this there is a we'll take an example from this. So any first order equation of x will represent a straight line. Now moving on, in physics, there is a function y equal to x square. Now this will not represent a straight line. Any equation in which x has only power 1 will represent a straight line, but if x has any other power than 1, it will not represent a straight line. Okay, so if you have a function y equal to x square, then how to go about it? So this is x, this is y. So again, you can all agree that if x is 0, y will be 0, so it will pass through this. Now see here, if x is positive, y is positive, but if x is negative, then also y is positive only, right? No? Because suppose if x is minus 1, y is 1, if x is plus 1, then also it's 1. So this equation, we say that this will give you parabola symmetric about y axis. Now why symmetric? Because if I change x to minus x, y remains positive only, right? So this graph is going to be like this. Now one thing you must have noticed, okay, we'll come to it later, a straight line slope is constant. Whatever slope it makes, it will not change with respect to points, fine. But if you draw a curve, its slope changes. Here slope is 0, then slope gradually increases here, fine. So there is a huge difference between a straight line and a curve. A straight line has a fixed slope, but a curve will have a different slope at different points. Now if we move on from here, and let us say we want to draw y equal to minus x square. So in this case, you can see if x is positive or negative, y will remain negative only, fine. So it will be symmetric about minus y axis. So the same thing, xy, and it will remain symmetric over this. So if you change x to minus x, y will remain negative y only. So this is symmetric about this. and if I move on from there and if I tell you to draw, let us say x equal to y square or x equal to minus y square. So you can see if y is positive or negative, x remains positive only. Y is positive or negative, x will remain negative. So this one will be something like this, and this one will be x remains negative only, it will remain like this. Okay, now these are some important graphs in parabola. Means this is it can be complicated. Okay, if you guys remember parabolic this projectile motion, then in this case in projectile motion we did something like y x. This is a projectile path, and if you guys remembered, then the projectile equation was some constant x minus some constant c1 x square. This is called equation of trajectory. So this kind of parabola will have this form. Okay, now moving on, we encounter this kind of function also, y equal to 1 by x. Okay, let me just write y is inversely proportional to x. Now again, this is not going to give you a straight line. I told you a straight line only comes when x is power 1. Here x is power minus 1. So in this case, what happens if you try to draw xy? If x is very large, okay, if x is very large, then you can see y is very small. So this is y, this is x. If x is very large, y will be very small. Let us say y, I am putting a dot here, and if x is 0, let us say very small, y is very high. Now this will give you a shape something like this. Now x can be positive also, x can be negative also. So actually one more curve comes here. This is called rectangular hyperbola, and you have to, these are called asymptotes. Okay, now means it will approach, it will touch x at x equal to infinity, y will be 0, so will not reach there only. Fine, so these are called asymptotes, means this kind of line, and this is called rectangular hyperbola. And this kind of thing we generally encounter in physics. Now in physics, now if you talk about 2D motion, 2D motion is also called motion in plane. So example will be parabolic, projectile motion. You can throw projectile like this from a building, you can throw a projectile like this also, it will go like this. You can have a circular motion, you can have elliptical motion, whatever. These are called motion in plane. And what happens here, we don't have to mention the time. When we draw this, we have to assume that as the body is moving, it is carrying clock with itself. We don't have to bother about time. Fine. So these are called trajectory. Actually, this is trajectory of projectile. This is trajectory of the projectile. If the body is moving in a circle, this trajectory is can be called circle. A body is moving in ellipse, this is elliptical. These are all called trajectories. Fine. But when we go to motion in one dimension, then Let us say motion in one dimension. I have simplest equation, simplest graph of this is the position and this is time. And suppose we have a graph like this. Now what we understand by this? Okay, so in one dimension, generally you will find that we'll draw time axis. Okay, always we'll draw one time axis to be on this direction. Now, to understand this, let us say 0, 0 given. So you can see at time t equal to 0, x has some value, right? Let us say x naught. So if I want to represent this idea, that means that suppose there is an origin somewhere here. The body is here, initially, x naught. Okay, at distance x naught. And the clock starts. So as the time changes, the position remains same. Right, no? So you can see time is changing, right? Now this all the points corresponds to the time only. X is fixed. So we have to assume that a clock have legs and they move. So even the particle is still, the clock is ticking, right? So time will always progress and the particle remains here only. So in mathematics, we can say that this is our x-axis. This case, x is constant or independent of time. Right. Now, x is constant and it is independent of time. Time always flows, so that's why the line comes out here. Now, so this is a description. This graph represents a particle which is at rest, right? Which has some distance from the origin and it is not moving, it's still. Now, what about if I give you an equation like this, xt and like this. Now, in this case, this is a straight line passing through the origin. Can you guess what kind of equation will be that? Okay, now, by the way, time we never represent in this direction. So, negative time we never represent in a graph. Now, if you guys remember y equal to x, if this was y, so it was representing like this, right? Now, so, it is an equation which represents, this represent uniform motion. Now what I mean by that, if you find slope here, slope is rise by run, so this is the angle theta. If I take a point here and a point here, this will be the rise and this will be run. And you know that a straight line slope never changes, so it is going to be something like, okay, rise is nothing but your change in position and run is nothing but change in time, right? This one will give you change in time, so rise by run will give you velocity. Velocity is delta x by delta. Now in this case, velocity remains constant. In this case, right? So, slope of xt graph gives you velocity. Okay, this is nothing but slope. Slope of xt graph. Now, quickly, what if I told you, okay, can you guess the equation, how that equation will look like? It will look like something x equal to ut kind of thing, okay, means the graph what we drew like this, something like this. Now what if x is equal to half a t square? Of course a is constant. How you will draw the graph? So here we can use this equation only when a is constant, and just assume this is a constant. So I can write this to be x equal to half a is a constant ct square. Now if you guys remember parabola, if I make t positive, x is positive. If I make t negative, x is positive only. So this graph will be symmetric about x axis. Okay, of course t can't be negative. So if you guys can understand, then this will be, if this is x, this is t, x equal to this kind of equation will give you a parabola like this. Now what if you have an equation like v equal to u plus at? So if you plot this v and t, this is a equation like this, y equal to c plus mx. So at time t equal to 0, v is u, right? And then this is going to be like this. Now one more, y equal to, let us say I have a equation y equal to minus half gt square. Okay, g is acceleration due to gravity. How this will look? So again, this is nothing but a parabola. This is constant. I can write y equal to minus ct square. So y is negative always. Okay, and the shape, because it's t square, if you plot this y and t, so this will be, y will be always negative, right? So this will be symmetric about minus y. So this is going to be something like this, right? Now these are all basic graphs. What we can, there are plenty to learn. You have to know the slope idea, how to read a graph, right? How we can convert one form to another form. So in the next video I will take an example where we'll apply all this scenario to solve some graph questions. Okay, thank you. I will see you in the next class.